his leg.
Wait, this one, let me get a picture. Good.
Yeah, it's starting to, oh, sorry.
It is really well done.
Yeah, it's got some years on it. That set was not easy. We refer to those as hover bench presses. That was my last heavy set. I had to get 2 hover reps followed by as many regular bench press reps as I could get with that weight. And that was actually a PR for me. So I'm super excited about that. And this is all part of a specialized bench press cycle that I put together for our DeFranco Insider membership website. It's a 3-week repeatable cycle. And I gotta tell you, this is the strongest I have ever gotten in that short period of time, especially without using any special equipment. No weight releasers, no bands, no chains, just good old fashioned barbell bench presses to improve your barbell bench press. The program revolves around different ways to perform isometrics, and I'm telling you, it really works. So if you're interested in the specific percentages and sets and reps and technique, definitely check out the DeFranco Insider. I'll put the link in the description of this video. Check it out. It's badass. But if you're not interested in any of that, welcome to vlog number 12. This is probably going to be the most packed vlog we have posted because I got a ton of stuff going on over the next couple days. Starting with today, I am going to finish. I have one more set on this workout, a drop set. I'm going to bang that set out. I'm going to get in my car. I'm going to drive to the gym. And at the gym, I'm going to meet one of my original disciples from the storage closet days. WWE superstar Enzo Amore is stopping by the gym today. He's in town for just 2 days. I haven't seen him in over a year, so we're going to record a podcast, let you guys see some behind the scenes of the podcast, and then we're just going to kind of shoot the shit, catch up. I'm sure we'll catch some funny moments whenever Enzo is at the gym. It's never dull. So let me finish up this last set, and I will see you guys at the gym.
Popping up.
Hey, what's up, asshole?
How you doing?
I wore them.
Oh, it's great.
I wore them when I wrestled. I know you got a lot of jerseys. I figured you'd get it. You know, your first pair of J's.
What match do you wear these in?
Ooh, against the Ascension, right when I got on the main roster. So it was probably like a month or two into it. Man, I can't call them, bro.
I wear a different pair every week, dude. So,
that's cool. Like, bro, it's like such a.
Yeah. Okay.
What's going on, bro?
How you been, bro? You good, man?
It was like I didn't forget about you. I got you. We're gonna do our best. Got you a little of this.
Hell yeah.
A little of this. A little of this.
So I'm gonna be taking all this stuff.
Yes. You still gotta eat.
Well, I've been lifting and cardio, but the whole eating thing, I'm not.
Mix. Those two, one scoop of each in a bottle of water, wash down 4 of these pills, drink that while you're training, protein shake when you're done, boom.
That's all I've ever needed, possible. Honestly. Like, I don't understand why people try to complicate the process. You know what I mean? That's how you speak to Enzo.
I've been changing up my workout for the past, like, 3 weeks. I do a deck of cards 3 days a week. Do you know what that is? Yeah. So I do.
Do you do a different exercise for each thing, or you just do
so? I just flip the card. I have the cards on me, bro. I've been doing it. So, me and Neville got after it with this. Flip the card. If it's a heart, it's a burpee. however many numbers, and then kings, queens, jacks are all 10, aces are 11. So burpees, body weight squats, sit-ups, and leg raises.
Really?
And bang through it, 17.
But Neville's, he's got to be doing some other lifting. The guy's
yeah, so I've been doing that, and then one core exercise at the end of the cards. So I've been doing that, then deadlifts, that, then squat, that, then bench, that, then power clean and press.
This is just a fun zone. This
is more I got my mouth full of asparagus, but we got some asparagus, some rice, some peppers, and there's chicken buried under there somewhere. But yeah, my girlfriend cooked it, very delicious.
Yeah, you better say it's but delicious.
Oh, I'm here with one of my ODs, original disciples from the storage closet. Back in the day, you've heard of the stories, the history of the great original 500 square foot storage closet, the likes of Brian Cushing, Dave Deal, Dahani Jones, Chris Hogan, who just won a Super Bowl, Vinny Churchu, and many others, including the most unlikely of them all, my man, EA All Day, better known as WWE Superstar Enzo Amore. What is up, my brother?
Bada boom, baby. How you doing?
The view looks good from over here, no? That's because we're in New Jersey, and I'm Eric Anthony, better known as EA All Day.
You didn't have a choice but to get strong in that warehouse.
I'll give credit where credit is due. You were a good bencher and a good deadlifter. You had a good deadlifter and a good jumper. Good box jumper.
Yes, box jump was my strong suit. Then I broke my leg in NXT, and I don't even think I can jump on the apron anymore.
When you made I'm sure we'll get into it, but when you made the original kind of highlight film for me to give to Triple H, that was you showed yourself deadlifting.
I did a 465-pound deadlift at 198 pounds.
For a couple reps. It was like a five-rep set.
Four or five-rep set with chains on it.
Yep.
And then I had the DeFranco's tattoo showed off in the video. Yes. I had my leg, one pant leg up, and the DeFranco's tattoo on the thigh, which we'll get into, I'm sure.
We got a lot to talk about. When you going to go out to the ring in a pair of wrestling trunks so the world can see? Anybody who follows wrestling, the little thing you did with Lana in the hotel room when you like took your pants off, was your boxers covering the DeFranco tattoo, or did they have to like make a conscious effort to kind of get that?
No, out of the I don't shot? Even think. I for one, Triple H was hands on deck that day.
Yeah, yeah.
So I don't think if he saw DeFranco's tattoo on my leg, he would have stopped, you know, rolling film.
We got over everybody's head. Everybody's
I mean, you're back home, you're broke, where everybody comes when they get cut from the NFL team, get kicked out of college. Your first stop before home is the gym.
Literally.
I can't tell you the amount of high school, college, pro guys that have walked in that gym.
Well, like, after before you got to go home to your pops and explain to them how you got kicked out of college, you might as well go get a lift in, you know?
And who walks in to the gym but EA, Enzo at the time, and I'm like, I'm still on the phone, and I'm like, wait, what the hell is he doing here? He's supposed to be in college. I finish up the conversation with Brenna, and I don't remember what you said, but I just remember, thankfully, you had boxers on, but you pulled your pants. Like, I don't think you said anything. I think you just pulled your pants down and, like, turned to the side. I'm like, why is Enzo pulling his pants down? At first, I thought, why did he draw my logo on his leg? And then my second response was like, yo, it's pretty good. Like, it's pretty detailed. You drew that, and you were like, no, it's a tattoo. And I was like, bull, dude, it's not, come on. We're like, what did you do? And then I saw, like, the little blood, like, it was fresh.
You came right from the tattoo. It was right across the street at that Hawthorne,
I forget. Pleasurable piercing.
Yeah. And I remember when the guy was doing it, I was like, hey, dude, this doesn't have to be good.
So then you come in, you pull your pants down, and you show me the tattoo, and I'm like, why the hell did you get that? And you were like, yeah, you're going to be seeing a lot of maybe lifetime free membership. And I was like, but I didn't make that negotiation with you. Like, that was a trainer that doesn't even work here anymore. But obviously, what am I going to do? Say like, hey, dude, you know, we don't have a signed contract, like deals off. So that's the story.
Yes, turned out to be the greatest $200 investment I've ever made in my life, bro.
Yeah, is that what it cost?
$200 It was like $200, man. It's pretty big too.
No, yeah, guys,
it's like a life-size T-shirt, like DeFranco symbol on my left eye.
Yeah.
This whole year for us has been surreal. The places I've seen, the people I've met, like a kid from Jersey growing up in a small town, you know.
Rest, if you make it, like you said, I know you don't have a match yet engraved in stone, but like how many WrestleManias did you watch as a kid and how big of a deal
was
that?
You know?
It's insane. To think you are eventually going to be on there.
And when I first broke into the business, Dusty Rose said to me, you could be good, you could be bad, or you could be different.
I love that.
And here I am walking in, and, you know, I had my back against the wall at DeFranco's. I mean, I was surrounded by Brian Cushing, you know, Miles Austin, all these guys.
You were there for them all.
And I was there, and I never stepped out of a workout or couldn't compete with these guys, but these guys are superior athletes. These guys are NFL-ready, you know, freshmen starting in USC in the national championship game, you know? Like, these are the guys I'm mixing it up with. When I got into the WWE, it was really no different. It was that DeFranco's mentality. I'm 5'10", 195 pounds. Like,
but you're used to be. That I guess I never even thought of that. It probably did prepare you in a way. My favorite moment, we're going back to favorite moments in the gym. I mentioned this to you because it's something that I heard you do at the gym, and that was ramble off every president's name. And I was telling these guys before we started recording, I was like, so Enzo did that during Monday night. It was probably on President's Day, right?
Yes, exactly. Right. I walk into Vince's office, and he's in there with, you know, Michael Hayes or a few people, and they go, "I will do it."
Well, I've got one thing I want you to do for me, okay?
We want to hear you say the presidents.
You want a little coffee or what? Huh?
I was like, oh,
how did they know? How did they know?
So you told them? I told the writer that I could say all the presidents in a row, and I wanted to do it. And so the writer put it on paper and handed it to Vince, but didn't write down all the names of the presidents, obviously, because it would have taken an hour. So he just write, Enzo will say the names of every president in chronological order, and Vince wanted to call my bluff. So I went into his office, I said the presidents in order, and he just looked at me and went, ha! Stuck his hand out, and I shook his hand, and that was it. So I'll say the presidents, and I bet you I could probably do it in under 45 seconds.
Wait. I'm going to, you know, we're going
to
make
it. I tried to get it in under 30 seconds, and I couldn't for an Instagram video a long time ago.
All of the presidents in chronological order. Under Enzo Amore. Ready?
Washington, Adams, Jefferson, Madison, Monroe, Adams, Jackson, Van Buren, Harrison, Tyler, Polk, Taylor, Fillmore, Pierce, Buchanan, Lincoln, Johnson, Grant, Hayes, Garfield, Arthur, Cleveland, Howard, Clinton, Kennedy, Roosevelt, Dad, Wilson, Harden, Coolidge, Roosevelt, Truman, Eisenhower, Kennedy, Johnson, Nixon, Ford, Carter, Reagan, Bush, Clinton, Bush, Obama, Trump.
11.66 seconds. So we might have to have somebody go back and analyze that if you got them all in, but I think you did.
Bro, before we close out, as we mentioned politics, I have a political rant that will blow minds, so I might as well use this platform on Joey D's. All right, we got issues. Figuratively speaking, we have issues of malnourishment in communities that would otherwise be flourishing if it weren't for apartheid, spearheaded by political figures who sit at the stratosphere of the political infrastructure and see to it the exponential growth of the corporate infrastructure. Or is that conundrum really just a liaison between factions of hierarchy that have endeavors that go beyond parliamentary procedures, proposals, referendums, filibusters, and legalities? I mean, hey, if you want to overindulge your eyes in between the lines of a communist manifesto, go ahead and be a Marxist. I mean, we've all been transients at some point or another, and I get excited even talking about it, but figuratively speaking, you got your right, you got your left. People in positions of power, it come at you from different angles. Could be acute, could be obtuse, but rarely ever is it perpendicular. I mean, sure, you got your Ayatollah Khomeinis, your Mahatma Gandhis, you got your Donald Trumps, you got your Vince McMahons, you got your Hillary Clintons, you got your Thomas Jeffersons, and you got your George Jeffersons. And hey, I've sat way up top high, deluxe apartments in the sky, and ranting on political jargon, but that's not why we're here today. So without any further ado, allow me to quote the performing artist Aubrey Graham, formerly known as Drake. Please hold on, we're going home. And when I get there, at least have the DC to leave me a porch light on. And if you didn't understand what I said, we could sit down over a cup of Joe and I could break this down for you in layman's terms.
By the side.
Where have you been wrestling?
WrestlePro. Used to wrestle in Pennsylvania with PPW.
Battle Club Pro, free combination wrestling. Did a couple things for the WWE, nothing crazy. One time NXT.
Do you mind if I dab this
dude? No, you go.
I don't get it.
Rope burn, hitting the ropes, hitting them hard, Calgary style, SWA.
Flies?
Flies.
Like the movement or like no, Spanish just flies?
Son of a bitch, I can't squeeze. Think of a way to pump.
And what this is?
This is called a Lurpee. It's a reverse lunge, and you want to explode straight out, like the sense of a burpee.
Wow.
All day.
You got a trademark on that?
Patent pending.
Okay.
He's got like a pump right now. Actually. It was good for him. The ball has been looking good with that. Shaved head. They actually wipe it down for each other each time. For a short wipe.
I know Chris is very sensitive. I am, because you're a subpar wiper.
You gotta get it from like right.
Is that the guy Kung Lao?
Right here, as you can see it, isn't it?
Mortal Kombat guy.
You gotta check out that
sternum. By Akum. Hey, give his tag the fastest. Oh, right on the neck.
I am here with Mike Jolly, a former UCLA football player and wrestler. He went on after that to coach football, own his own training facility. We're just talking a little bit about his acting career. Did a little bit of that. We might have shared some funny stories there.
I miss you a hard time, man.
Till finally.
But recently, a couple years ago, invented one of the most innovative pieces of training equipment that I have personally ever seen. It's more, to me, it might be one of the most important and necessary pieces of equipment that I've ever come across, especially for combat athletes, but really for all athletes. And that's the main thing we're going to talk about here today. The piece of equipment I'm referring to is called the Iron Neck. Can you explain to the audience what made you want to invent a piece of equipment to strengthen the neck?
I played football at UCLA, like you mentioned, and I played with two guys that we've already lost. And we've lost them because of CTE, chronic traumatic encephalopathy. One was Lewis Sharp, and he's still alive, but he's in the state penitentiary. And the other one was Mark Tuinen.
Yep.
And Mark, you know, basically committed suicide with a huge, massive overdose of heroin 6 months after he retired from the Dallas Cowboys. Wow. Now, Mark had tons of money, big family, 3 Super Bowl rings, but he was so severely depressed because of CTE. It's the same thing that Junior Seau had.
Yep.
And, you know, we know that Junior Seau shot himself in the chest because he wanted to save his brain for science so they could dissect it and prove that, yeah, he had CTE, and that's why he was so severely depressed. It's a degenerative disease that really can make you very, very angry. Severe depression. I lost these two guys. I started doing a little research, and there was some research that said that, you know what, concussions probably contribute to CTE. And one of the things, you know, I've spoke at the Combine a couple times to the strength coaches, and I speak at the Glacier Clinics, and one of the things that I want to stress, you have to know what a concussion is. You know, you see a blown out knee. You know the ACL got torn. You saw it, you saw it happen on the field. They replay it. It's disgusting to watch. But you get it. And as a strength coach, you go, okay, I got to strengthen my quads. I got to strengthen the hamstrings, the tibialis. I got to strengthen all those muscles that affect the knee joint so that we can prevent that knee injury from happening. So one of the things that I like to teach everyone is what happens in your brain when you're concussed. When you get a blow to the body or to the head, it does not have to be to the head. A body blow that snaps your neck will give you concussion just as easily as a blow to the head will.
That's important. Okay, to know.
And that's really important to know. Then you start understanding why neck strength's important. Because you're getting concussed and you didn't even get a blow to the head. Yeah. Why is that happening? Well, you have a weak neck and your head's snapping around. So neck strength obviously is going to dissipate that.
Yeah.
So the key was, how am I going to find a way to strengthen the neck and not damage the spine? Increase range of motion, increase flexibility, which are the other two keys to preventing concussions. This is the same height.
Yep.
Okay, so you can slide it up and down. Okay, so the best warm-up is just a spin, because that just gets blood flowing, and you're not moving your head yet. Just spin. And it just throws the force around. Just a couple spins in each direction. It's good. I like to have the kids put their hands behind their back.
Yep.
Because they do that, it just helps them stop body motion.
Yeah.
They're here, they start getting into it. You have full range of motion.
The key, is keeping everything still, right? Just your neck is moving.
Yeah, because
often you get the shoulder.
Exactly. That's better. And then the chin strap's important in the beginning. You know, just it's a lot for safety. So if you get some dingling in here and he goes like this with the thing on his head, it could fly across the room, you know. And a lot of the coaches will put tape marks on the floor. So you know, that's 10 pounds, that's 20 pounds. And they come with a chart so that you know what it is. So stretch that back a little bit more. I'll just do the spin, pirouette. Good, the other way. Now you can feel how that's throwing the force around your neck.
Yeah, and the core too.
Core, yeah, it engages the glutes. All right, now let's just do look left, look right. Now, full range. Now it's always good to touch the shoulder, right? So all the way here and all the way over there. Full range of motion, there you go. So remember, three keys to concussion: strength, range of motion, and flexibility. You don't want to lose range of motion. This will actually help you increase the range of motion. And now the weakest muscle, the platysma, is working hard. This is the muscle that will keep you from smacking your head on the ground when you fall on your back. Tips of the sternocleidomastoid are working too. Good. Keep going. Good form. Okay, now face front. Now we're going to do the spin with the look left, look right. So what I want is, I want six look left, look rights with every 360 degree spin. Good. And this is good because you're always going to be in a little different spot as you're doing it. So you're hitting all those different angles.
Start to feel everything, the obliques, glutes.
Oh yeah, take some pressure off. Now I'm gonna dial up some tension on here. I'm gonna give you about 7-8 pounds resistance, okay. And now we're gonna do the Stevie Wonder. All right, and just start off, you know, just start off small, and then as you get it down, you get bigger. Good form. And really push the limits of your range of motion. That's actually great form.
I feel the range of motion opening up. I felt a lot tighter in the beginning.
Yeah. The goal here is to try to put the head and neck in every position, face out and out, away from the attachment point, in every position it can be in, out on the football field or on the wrestling mat, and go. So you're ready to dissipate the force of a blow to the head. While we're facing out, let's do the turtle. So it's just straight out, straight back. Good. Really extending. Excellent. You see how Joe, he's going straight out? So important it's straight out like that. You don't want to dip your chin down at all. Good. Excellent. Now your splenius cervicis and splenius capitis come all the way down from your skull, all the way down to here. And you're going to feel that all the way down to those muscles.
Yeah, you feel it to your mid-back.
Yep. Good. And I'm holding. Small look, left look, right. Extend it even more. There you go, stretch it out. Lock neck and body turns. So now you want to get down into a good stance. You can move the band down a little bit because you're going to squat. So hands are out in front. Your nose is going to follow the tip of your fingers and you can get a good full range of motion body turn. And a little bit faster. Chin up just a hair, chin up. There you go. Good form, good. You jump the quarter turn, keep cranking. Good.
Hell
okay,
yeah.
Now we're gonna go nose up, nose down, okay? So now you're gonna start here and you're gonna draw a diagonal line. You're gonna come up on your right toe and you're gonna try to touch the ceiling with your nose. Really extending the neck. Get back up, Joe. He's cheating. Okay, go ahead.
You said up on this leg when I...
Yeah, as you push it, yeah. All the way up. There you go. Good. Just like that. Really stretch it up there. Perfect. Full position. You want to make sure your neck's strong in that position. Good. Great. Switch. Nose over here now. Nice. Stretch it up.
Wow.
Feels pretty good, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a great feeling when you finally get done.
Yeah,
you feel a little bit taller, don't you?
Yeah, actually, I do feel like I'm kind of like took my head and pulled it out of my...
Yeah, it sort of lines everything.
It's so much different than the like pump you get in your neck from using a neck harness. It feels like the deeper muscles, like it's almost like literally from your spine out feels like it's activated. Totally different feeling, but I still, it's crazy. I still feel like I don't feel locked up where I can't move.
Yeah.
It's unlike anything.
And that's one of the things I've that used. The wide receivers are always worried about. Oh, I can't, lose my range of motion because I got to be able to find the ball. Like, you're not going to lose
it. You're
going to
gain more.
You're going to gain it. And you're going to be protected when you're in one of those vulnerable positions when you get hit.
Yeah.
Try to get it as most like what you're going to experience out there.
Yeah.
The beginning, warm up slow.
Yeah.
But then you can start cranking it.
Yeah.
And with the lock neck body turns, as ballistic as you can make it.
Okay.
As fast as you can make it.
Yeah.
Because that's the one exercise that the neck has to react to your body. So it's like reacting to a field condition. Because your body's stopping, and then the neck stops. It goes, oh, and it has to react, and it has to come back the other way.
How important is the sequence to those?
You want to warm up with the spin, just get some blood flowing,
oh.
And then the look left, look right, you're next. Yeah. And after that, it doesn't
after
matter.
After that, it doesn't matter. But would you, so you want the dynamic stuff, you want to just make sure you're warmed up first, but.
Right.
Hey, dude, this doesn't have to be good.